humble peasants. We need a good leader.
Is this true about King John? That he's a blight on the land and a power-hungry tyrant?
And he doesn't brush his teeth either.
Perhaps someone should speak with his highness. After all, sometimes even your best friends will tell you. Ah, the beautiful Maid Marian approaches. See how radiant she is in the morning light. How delicate, like a thistle. How pristine, how gentle.
I wondered what was scaring all the deer off.
Milady, might I have a word with you?
Oh, are you some bandit come to carry me off? Come to rob me and then hold me for ransom? Some derelict, ill-washed, unmannered, come to transgress upon my purity?
No. Were you expecting someone else?
No, I just had this dream that... Never mind. Who are you, knave?
I am Robin of Locksley, squire of the lowlands and heir to the estate south of Sherwood.
That's a bit windy. What do your friends call you?
Scary.
Well, pray tell, Scary. What business do you have to speak to me in such a rude manner?
It's only that I wish to speak about that wretched King John. That rat, that slug, that pond scum.
He's my uncle.
I hear he's a good dancer.
Robin of Locksley, perchance I have heard of you.
Milady, perhaps you may think me bold, but I must speak and unleash the torrents of feeling that I suddenly have for you, your beauty, and your being. Do you believe in fate, Milady?
I believe that I do everything towards an end, that I was put here for a purpose, and it leads me and makes me, and its very presence seems indeed heavy.
Yeah, well, I believe it is that old world fate that has chosen this day for our path to cross, that you and I were chosen for each other, and to rebel against our destinies would be sheer folly. That you and I were destined to meet and rebel.
And that line works.
Please, Blake, whatever is to come, whatever lies on the road ahead, remember me in a kind light, and I shall ever be thy servant.
Lose a contact?
Announcing the arrival of His Royal Highness, the reigning monarch, and one heck of a dancer, King John. Now here's Johnny!
It is my lord.
Johnny! Why, you two are cuter than two spy puppies in a wagon road. Give him all your hand, legs.
How strange you speak, sire.
Why, I'm speaking the king's English.
Uncle, has I met this strapping young man?
No, and I thought I'd pretty well strapped everybody.
Be not afraid. Come forth.
Sire, I am Robin of Locksley, and I've heard some pretty nasty things about you.
This from a bushwhacker?
I never struck a bush in my life. Why, there are friends lifting their leafy arms to pray. Why, I don't think I shall ever see a poem as lovely as a bush.
Needs work.
Say, you and I ought to butt heads about now. I've just seized all your land and estate.
What?
Now see, it's things like that that give you a bad name.
So you defy me. Is that why you're shooting at?
I will fight in justice to the highest throne in the land.
Okay, why?
Robin.
My bow.
And I shall take my bow.
Ooh.
Wait a minute.
That's right, pal. I ain't fiddling around here.
Well, I wanted to learn archery, like all the other kids, but Mom made me practice 1 hour every afternoon. You know how mothers are.
You, sir, are an enemy of the state. Caesar.
Wait, wait! Your shoes are tied.
You go ahead.
What do you expect from the downtrodden poor? First, I have to blow that stupid horn. Then, I have to make all the announcements. And now he wants me to make arrests, like his arm is broken or something.
Oh, Uncle, must you be so?
I am okay.
Yes, but you run off every boy that looks cross-eyed at me. I mean, it's hard enough to meet people living in a castle, and he pulls this routine off with every eligible bachelor I run into. I'm going to end up a nun!
See? She talks like that when no one's around. I must get back to the castle to warn Sheriff about young Robin. I'll bet he's sure going to be a burr under my saddle. One.
Which one?
My sister, third from the
Maybe we ought to go back to rhyming.
You won't like it.
I'm a bit confused. You're a witch?
Right.
No, you're a witch one.
That's my sister, witch one.
And she knows which way?
Of course she knows me. I'm her sister.
You know, it's a shame that scientists won't invent aspirin for years yet.
I am just trying to answer your question. The one you asked earlier.
Which time?
That's my other sister. I must be off.
You can say that again.
Jan approaches the sheriff now. I'd best take my leave through the woods.
Which way?
Yes.
Get off.
Ah, Friar Tuck, why travel you through this perilous forest?
Just an afternoon constitutional.
Was that the witch of the woods you were conversing with?
I believe it was. She just departed.
Which way?
Are you sure you want to ask for that?
Skip it. Know you of the bandit Robin Hood?
Robin Hood. What was that name again?
Don't toy with me, Friar! I have the power of the state behind me!
Hood. You know, I used to know a family of Hoods on the east side. In fact, they were my neighbors.
They were neighborhoods?
You ought to talk to that witch.
Which way?
That way.
Never mind.
Yet he still had
sergeant for his troops. He needed someone with strength, but not necessarily too bright. He needed the bronze to go with his brains. Little did he know he would meet such a giant in the most commonplace of surroundings, a falling log over a river. It was here he was to meet up with his greatest fighter and best friend, Little John. Here's how it happened.
Oh, I see that I must cross the river. Well, as they say, why did the chicken cross the road? Which I never did understand. So I don't know why I bothered to say that. I shall step on this log to test its strength.
Okay, Toby, one side, coming through.
You want me to stand aside?
That would be good.
And I say you stand aside while I cross.
Hey, I thought of it first.
Yes, but I weigh more than you and your relatives.
You challenge me? Do you know who I am?
I sometimes have trouble remembering who I am.
I am Robin Hood, outlaw, bandit, and protector of the downtrodden.
Ain't you the one who spends a little too much time in the forest?
Well, trees get downtrodden too. I bet you knocked over several coming here.
Sir, prepare to defend yourself.
What is it with everyone lately? First the sheriff, and now this moose. Everyone's been so touchy lately.
You speak with noble jest, but does your staff have such agile ways?
A contest, is it? Well, you incredible Hulk, where do you come from?
I have a hogan just on the other side of the woods.
Ah, a Hulk's hogan. Well, brave sir, I shall not disappoint you. I shall find a staff, and we shall have the fight of the century.
Low, parry, thrust, lift, flaps, down.
The hometown challenger, John Little John, weaves in at just the same as a well-fed ox and uses some of the same expressions. He is using a sure wood seven wood, a big favorite in the circuit. John, how do you see the match shaping up?
Well, I plan to use my usual techniques.
Which are?
Oh, you know, bash in the head, bash in the bread basket, and of course, a loud language.
Do you foresee a great battle?
Well, I'll try to be on my toes. He's young, wiry, and kinda short.
Do you see that working to his advantage?
Only if I can't bash him in the head or bash him in the bread basket. Excuse me, I need to wonder up.
Now let's try getting the word in for our other combatants. Robin!
Yeah?
How do you see the battle shaping up today?
Well, it's too early to tell. But I'd like to say a big hello to all the guys back at Dimitri's.
Now, do you see this as just another fight? Or as we've all been led to believe, a very big career move?
I like to take it as they come. As you know, there are no big fights, only big fighters. Real big fighters. Now, if only I could find a quarterstaff, then we could get on with the festivities.
There you have it! Little John versus Robin Hood!
Sir, I am ready. Advance and do battle.
This will only take a moment, and then I shall, now, where in the world?
Sir, I am ready.
Yeah, just a mo. Say, when I came in, wasn't I carrying, like, this really long stick?
You mean like a quarterstaff?
buck and a quarter for it. What could I have done? I know when I left the Hogan this morning, I had it. Let's see. I put on my brown slacks and...
There seems to be trouble down in the field.
Somebody stole my staff.
I am ready.
You're already sick. I can't find my staff.
To support a workman who blames his tool.
Shut up!
Well, far be it from me to take the advantage. Here, take mine.
Why, thank you. Sir, I am ready.
Wait a minute.
Something's wrong here. Look, you don't want to play? I'll take my staff and go home.
Just a minute, will you?
There seems to be a problem with the equipment. Was that enough to go around?
Sorry. I didn't bring enough for the whole class.
Shut up. Why, thank you.
The field is set and play should begin shortly.
Sir, I am ready.
I forgot what we were supposed to do.
Get up here.
Fine. Isn't it? And it's Robin's love for her that, well, I guess I'm our story. Robin had long escaped the long arm of the sheriff and the crown, but now it was becoming painfully obvious that he had the support of the people. He was now their champion. He was now their hero. And most importantly, he would fight their fights so that they would not have to leave the house. From then on, Little John would start bringing in new recruits to the Sherwood Army, and Robin would start his second part of the Share the Wealth plan.
All right, let's go. Line up right here. Straight down, line up. Eyes forward. Smoke them up. Now, he will volunteer for service in battle against oppression and tyranny. We like to see spirit. We like to see strength. And also, I like to see it shine on those moccasins. Now, I'm not going to pretend that this is going to be easy. It's not all romping in the woods and chasing small animals for sport, you know? Here is our fearless leader now, our guiding light, our inspiration, and our mentor. Sir!
Anybody seen my arrow?
No.
Some new recruits, sir?
Fine.
Men!
These aren't men.
No, sir.
You noticed?
Yes, sir. Almost from the first.
Almost? Just how long have you been living in these woods, Little John?
These are the finest in the land, ready to do battle at any moment's notice. I call them my Minutemen.
They're not men.
Okay. They're Minutemaids.
Oh, well. As long as you see them worthy.
They are the best, I assure you. You were going to tell us the second part of your plan today, sir.
Right. Today we shall begin phase two of our battle plan. As you know, we have robbed and pillaged every nobleman and fat cat that came into these woods. We've done well in that respect.
Yes, sir. Quite a booty.
Now we take what we stole from the rich and give them to the poor.
Huh?
That's right. We redistribute the wealth.
Wait a minute. You mean we give it back?
After all we've done?
Do what? We help the needy.
We're living under a tree, sir. Eating animals I don't even like to look at when they're alive. Don't we qualify?
It's part of our chivalrous training and high moral standards.
Wait a minute. You mean we don't keep anything?
Problem with that?
Yeah, no one told us that when we joined up.
We didn't know this was a non-profit organization.
It's our calling!
Had we known that, we wouldn't have accepted the call.
What? Why? I am ashamed of you all. To think that you fought, the fight we fought, the sight we sought, would come to naught.
That's what they've been taught.
I am distraught.
Now wait. That might play pretty well. Good ad campaign. Let's see. They rob from the rich and give to the poor. It scans well.
Yeah, and in its very nature, we'll have more of the downtrodden in flight with our...
This pipe we call that?
Ow, stop it! Can't you see it? Years from now, the stories that will be told, the legend that will abound, the precedent we will have set.
Wait a minute. You're telling me we don't keep anything.
I said they were good, but they don't retain much.
Well, go get more silver and gold. That way, we may begin our campaign for the needy and poor.
So, we rob from the poor and...
No, we rob from the poor!
information you don't.
Oh, how's that coming along?
We're halfway there.
Meaning?
We found the dump. Now, if only we had some ammunition. You also have to speak to a ladies' club.
Who are they?
The Mothers of the American Revolution. Let's see. After that, yeah, we'll have some time for some robberies.
Good. Good. Only...
What is it, Robin? Lately it seems so... I don't know. Far away. So distant.
Oh, it's nothing really. It's just...
Hey, if you can't tell me, then who can you tell?
Well, it's just... I'm so lonely.
Huh?
Oh, you know how I feel about a certain someone.
Who?
I guess the whole camp's talking about it.
They are?
I know it shows, but I can't help it. It's how I feel.
Say, hey, look at the time.
It's just, I don't know how.
What?
How can I see Maid Marian?
Maid Marian? Oh, right. Of course. Her.
Who do you think I meant?
No! It's nothing!
You didn't think!
No! Wait. You want to see King John's niece?
I see her everywhere. I see her in my dreams. I see her in the trees. I see her in the river.
You should be tired of her by now. Wait. I know who can help us. Tuck! Not Duck! Prior Tuck. He goes to the castle often to plead for the people. He can think of something.
Prior Tuck? Prior?
Present.
Robin has a problem.
I know. It's all over camp.
Maid Marian?
Yes.
I just wanted to be sure. I mean, we've spent a lot of time together.
What?
Nothing. Speak with him. I need to figure out the shower schedule.
Take one for yourself out of petty cash.
Which?
So, what got you down, Bucky?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I lead a pretty full life. You know, with Robin, ducking the sheriff, stuff like that.
But you need something more. You need love.
Silly, isn't it?
No, of course not. But seeing the niece of the man you hate most, tricky.
If only I knew what was going to happen. If only I knew how to proceed. If only there were someone who could foresee the future.
Bubble, bubble, struggle. I find balance amongst the rubble.
The Witch of the Wood!
Which way?
This way!
Don't start that again.
Oh, you, noble witch, I seek your counsel.
Young Robin, you who talks to trees and roams the woods and deeps.
You'll find this conversation stale.
My words to give advice for sale.
And in my garden I plant a bowl.
Just have to mess up the rhyme thing now, don't you?
Oh, you who sees the future, tell me if my path will cross that of the glorious Maiden.
I do not speak with those who doubt.
But there's no need for you to pout.
Hey, I can't rhyme. Nobody does.
And I consider that a plus.
History.
So, you need to seek your fate.
Well, it couldn't hurt.
Take a chair.
What?
I mean, a tent.
Oh.
By the shadows of the raven's wing. By the powers of earth and sky.
By the shores of Kitchen Gooby!
Hey, I do this alone.
Sorry.
Where was I?
Raven's wing, earth, and sky.
Right.
By the spirits of the netherworlds, I call upon thee to show me the panorama of the futures here. And now.
Anything?
cultures intermingle and entwine. It ravels before me like the thread of time.
Pretty good, huh?
What did you see?
Oh, right. I seen some conquest, rather. Some vigilant mission. You seek to find power.
No.
Well?
No.
Your car keys.
Love.
Love!
That's right. How do you do that?
This kid is going to be a piece of cake.
Huh?
The object of your love has escaped you and is far beyond your reach.
Wait a minute. Tell me her name.
It's Faye.
Not even close.
No, her name's vague.
No, it's not.
You're confusing me.
This coming from somebody named Witch Way.
I can see the letters in her name. The first letters are
M. M.
That's what I said. M. Her name is Marie Melissa Mortimer.
Mortimer.
Hey, what's in it? Some you like to be married.
That's her! Mary!
Vardon was right. Maid Mary. Aha! Maid Mary. I can foresee trouble along the way. These woods are full of traitors. And you, Robin of Locksley, will be foiled by a woman.
Oh no. You mean
you should take care and beware.
You mean I should stay clear of Maid Marian? That's kind of hard to believe.
Hey, you think I made all this stuff up? Summon approaches. Be on your guard and beware of the woman.
I must heed her advice. I must watch myself at all times. Which is kind of hard to do without pure wedding blood. 'Tis her!
Oh, Robin, I have come to warn you.
Yet too late. And keep your distance.
You shun me?
Nothing personal.
Does my countenance repel you thus?
No, no. What does that mean anyway?
Come close that I may whisper in your ears.
Yeah, and then what?
Please, the woods have ears.
Oh, what you know? Corn has ears. The woods have tree leaves. Trust me on that one. Something like that? Oh, no.
What have I done that is making you keep your distance?
I wish you wouldn't carry on so.
I have come at great danger just to be with you.
Yeah, well.
I saw you in that.
and do nothing.
Only there was some way, some means, as to enter the castle as a group without arousing suspicion. I know, the festival.
No, what?
Festival. It says here that, hey!
Hey, we're short on Friday, okay?
It says here that there is to be a festival at the castle. All townspeople are invited.
And that's how we get inside. All of Robin's band of merry persons can disguise themselves as peasants.
Exactly. And once inside, we can render where they are keeping young Robin and render him free. And you... Why didn't you tell me you were going to sneeze?
Hey! It's not one of those things I can plan, you know? I'm sorry!
Gosh, these poor people in front, they might not even want to hear the end of the legend. Why don't you carry around a handkerchief?
I said I was sorry.
Yeah, right. Well, they're gonna have to dry off. We'll continue the legend of Robin Hood in a few minutes, but please don't tarry long.
Hey, I'm working this way.
Sugar! Fresh sugar!
One size, nice girl. I got perishables here.
Stick this in your hat and call the macaroni.
Say, are you going to the festival?
On my way. Are you going to the Scarborough Fair?
Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Headed that way. I sell spices.
Oh, you must be the woman for all seasons.
That's right. Merchant of Venice. Say, what have you heard of this Robin Hood?
I heard his estate had been seized, and he'd gone to challenge King John with that army he's leading. Also, he's got the blue symbols for that lovely Maid Mary. But they had some sort of fight. And the Sheriff of Nottingham vowed to have Robin's head on a stake. Then there came the rumor that the Sheriff had captured their Robin. But there is a plot on the foot to effect his escape.
That's all rumor?
Yeah, and for anyone who's missed the first act?
Well, I suspect we must hie ourselves to the castle.
Well, you can take the high, and I'll take the low.
Let us away.
We have inside, all safe and sound.
Hot day, and I figure all those other cutthroats will try to bust him out of jail for bigger.
If by thy words you mean you suspect some practice, I concur.
Hey, I'm speaking the king's English. I don't know that joke. Say, the west wall is needing a little mending. Need to shore up that hole we made during the last jousting tournament. Get a Rockwell to tend to it, one from the Saxons. I owe them a few political favors, you understand?
Sire, it would do better to show no favors. What with all that bad blood between the Saxons and the Normans? I respectfully suggest you choose an artisan from the Normans.
Fine, get a Norman on them.
Excellent, my lord. Norms! Oh, no!
But keep an eye peeled for any imposters. I just know them folks is gonna pull some shenanigans. Ah, Marion, you look glowing and the steak smelling your travel.
I'm sorry if I present a dapper countenance.
What do you got there?
This is show and entertainment for your amusement, subject to your approval, of course.
Gimme. Now is the winter of our discontent, made glorious by the summer of York. Kind of hard to sing, ain't it?
It's not a musical.
Take this back to Bill Shakespeare and tell him that this reeks.
Why don't you tell him? You're King John, you know.
What's this called, anyway? Richard III. Hey, I don't want anything around here called Richard. Where is he, anyway?
I don't know. Last I've seen of the man, he was talking to Francis Bacon and giving him some money or something.
Now is the winter of our discontent. Who talks like that, anyway? That Shakespeare needs a haircut, too.
Given it to one who shunned me. A man, nay,
And then, when all the guards were asleep, I fashioned my bed to make it look as if I were sleeping. Then, I began to dig. Slowly at first, I made my way through the rich earth, tunneling through the hours. Then, after inching my way along, finally came here.
So, how did you end up back here in your cell?
What? Back here? This is where I came up. I shouldn't complain, though. My other cell was really small. At least here, I can go for a walk whenever I like.
Oh, Robin, why did they wish me gone?
Oh, that. Well, it's my own fault. I shouldn't be talking to witches.
Witches? You call me a witch? I will not be made sport of.
Hey, don't go. Boy, the days are getting shorter. Oh well. Now is the winter of my discontent. Now where have I heard that from?
You were speaking of witches.
Oh, that ratty witch in the wood betrayed me.
Which way?
In every way she could think of. I think I signed a lease on this place.
Robin, we must get you out.
That would be good.
A little bit of Italy right here! Step right up and enjoy the pleasures of the Roman!
Wait, there are too many witnesses. We will be found out.
Hey, when will you come back and...
Where is that scoundrel? I'll have his head!
And what scoundrel is that? For we have such an assortment here at the castle.
Ah, Maid Marian, how sharp your tongue is. But after I rid the land of the knave, then you shall be mine.
Methuselah, how are you? How have you been? Everything okay with you?
shall attempt to dematerialize a person and bring them back right before your very eyes.
I bet I can name someone I'd like to see pulled apart.
We'll need a covered box of the sort. This should do nicely.
Oh, that will be necessary. I have something better in the storage room.
Like what?
Like those old bowling boots we never use.
Step aside, young lady, and we shall continue with the show.
But
one side, kid, you follow me. Ah, the great oracle returns with my sword. What took you so long?
I couldn't find our sword, but I found this one sticking out of a rock. So I yanked it out, and this crowd gathered around me.
And?
I've got this great job opportunity now. Listen, I think it'd be a good career move.
What'd they say?
They want to make me king.
Oh, you don't want that.
I don't?
No, you have to wear all those stuffy robes. And there's no advancement.
What's this about being king?
Nothing. Now I shall show you there's nothing underneath this box.
No!
What? Robin Hood! I'll show you how to make him disappear.
Is it morning already? Is it
Now to make him disappear.
I'll make even shorter work of the deed.
Abracadabra, hocus pocus, tippecanoe and Robin too. Let's hope that worked.
Allow me.
I'll help with the trick.
Wait!
This is to prove he's still there. And again and again.
This is great. Go ahead.
Now, son, we shall see if the slippery outlaw has evaded the specter of death itself. What? He's gone!
I'll bet that rascal's gone back into the castle. Get him!
Yes, sir!
We've not a moment to lose. Little John, cover the gates. Sue, Frida, Annie, and the rest of you. Cover the exits.
Right.
Why, you're Friar Tuck?
I know, great disguise, huh? Do you know where Robin is?
He must have gone back the way he came. Hurry!
Hey, how about this? This thing has a sunroof.
There he is!
Hello! Anyone there?
What ho?
Huh?
Who said that?
How'd you get in there?
It's the heck out of me.
I went to see Robin Hood in his cell. When he escaped, I followed him down his hole.
Do we have Blue Cross?
Say, honey. You know the outlaw pretty well.
Don't talk to me, buddy, until you put that sword there.
Oh, right. Say, you know Robin Hood, right?
You live in the woods. You get to know the clientele. Bandages.
You got any bandages? I have this rat theory about bleeding to death.
You know how he thinks.
How you have to worry about. It's when.
Where would he go? Where would he be right now?
Hog into the woods, of course. You're not going to help me, are you?
The woods!
I didn't think so. Oh well.
Did you see him?
No.
Did you try to mention him?
Dungeon.
Semantics. Who cares? Did you look?
Yes.
Excuse me.
He's not there?
No. Did you check the parapet?
Huh?
The top of the walls?
He's not there.
He must have gone through the main hall into the great corridor.
That's where the king went.
We must find the king and install him. Somehow delay him.
One of you wouldn't be a nurse by any chance?
Good. That's where you come in. You find the king and distract him.
Right. What will you do?
I'll wait here.
You? Let me worry about that. Go, hide into the king.
Right. News for it! You got any news for it?
I know, I heard him. He must be around here somewhere. These outlaws are crafty. They have ways of hiding. But where could he hide? And how? I must consider the bandit's mind. If I were a bandit, where would I hide?
Boggles the mind, doesn't it?
I bet those magicians were a part of his band. I'll have their heads too, if I can find them.
Should I tell him he was the one that got me with the sword, right?
You're the witch of the wood, right?
For the moment.
You can see past all disguises. Tell me, where are these brigands hiding?
You really don't know?
Speak, witch, if you know something.
Talk about and see the forest for the trees.
Riddles. You speak in riddles?
What has 13 legs and...
Speak or I'll run you through!
Oh, now there's a threat.
I warn you.
Sheriff,
Harris here. I mean, here. Sire.
Do you want your house?
No, sire. I fear they have escaped.
I don't see how. Here, let's sit beneath this tree and think on it a while.
Doesn't give us much hope in the present government, none does it.
The way I see it, the walls are too high to fall over, and the drawbridge is still up, so they must be around here somewhere.
So it would appear.
Then they're hiding out under our very noses.
My thoughts exactly.
Listen, I just thought of something.
What, sire?
Robin has a screaming haunts for my niece, right?
You mean he is smitten with the maid?
Listen, I don't care if he's flat or no. That's what we got him to do. What we need to do is take Maid Marian hostage and get word to him that if he don't turn himself in, we'll take our revenge out on her.
Sire, you would do that to your own kin?
Listen, this ain't nothing. You should read this play called Richard III. He lopped off heads right and left. What a sweetheart. Now, what we need to do is find Maid's maid. Oh, hey there, Mayor.
Say,
Listen, we haven't got a problem. We was wondering if you could help us out.
Sure. How'd you come in?
Oh, I don't mean you no harm.
Don't listen to them.
Who said that?
I've been calling out for help for an hour.
Trees, he hears.
I will not be a subterfuge to any party ensnaring Noble Robin Hood.
Did you hear someone speak a moment ago?
Nah.
Did you?
Nope.
Did you just speak?
No.
You're not trying.
Damn him!
Sorry.
Now pronounce you man and wife. The sheriff.
I better get into this, otherwise we'll be here all day.
Hey! No fair! Double teaming!
Aha! You thought you could outplay me, the greatest swordsman in the county!
I wish you would have told me that before this all started.
Now, I shall run you through!
Wait! You can't do that.
Tell why not?
I just married you two.
Huh?
Listen, not only do we have Robin Hood's lover, but we have his rat-haired maid as well. He's sure to show up now.
Good one, Saturn. Rise, knave. Make one false move and I'll cut out your heart.
If that's your best offer, I'll stay here.
Arise and move next to the area near it.
Okay, but
watch that thing.
Wait, didn't there used to be a tree here?
Go on.
Be still, big man. Now, what's this about a marriage?
Now that no good snake Robin Hood's gonna pull some real weenie trick now. We have to look out for some disguise.
Of course, sir.
Now, let's keep an eye peeled.
Right.
What'd I tell you?
So, he chooses to laugh in my face. Wearing the same disguise I once wore to catch him. I shall thwart him.
He's gonna do what?
Sword.
I've got one right here.
Halt!
So, Friar Tuck, I did not see you enter the castle.
Hey, what's the big deal? I got my hand stamped.
Tis not you that interests me. Tis your apprentice, mom.
Oh, him? You don't have to worry about him. He's just my nephew. A real chip off the old block.
Oh, a chipmunk, eh? Sir, I call you a liar, a knave, a thief, and a traitor!
Yeah, well, you're beasting!
Huh?
I think he means me.
Hood!
That's right, Cheryl. I'm right here. And this town's not big enough for the two of us.
So, finally, the outlaw decides to fight his own battles.
Run, Robin, run!
Now we see who is greater. You? Or I, who have right, good, and the will of the people on my side.
Rob, he's the greatest swordsman in the country.
Look, I don't have anything against you personally.
Then you shall find my sword against thy ribs.
Watch it, Robin. He cheats.
What am I guessing?
A horse! My kingdom!
Yes, and then the kingdom shall be free of your tyranny until the return of the rightful King Richard.
Announcing the return from the Crusades of Richard, the rightful king of the Britons.
Talk about timing.
Sorry, everyone. Went off on something of a tangent, which was a frightful deal. What with the countryside running amok with rapscallions and charlatans, all sorts of chivalry to instill, with malaise beyond comprehension.
Huh?
I say, can't you understand me? After all, I am speaking the king's English.
Oh, man!
What did he say?
Gallicans!
Something about scallions.
I love seafood.
You thought I was mad.
I'll never understand politics.
I say, did I miss much?
I knew that I would try. It is always such the case. Good over evil, love over hate.
Mood of Ryan. Ain't you dead yet?
Well, I'm not feeling my best.
Neo, Robin of Locksley.
I'm yours to command, Your Majesty.
By the power and weight of the crown and all the power invested in me, to grant you this noontide. Today, you are a knight. Arise, Sir Robin of Locksley. Today,